Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for coming to our concert. I'm Paige Howell. I'm the chair of the Performing Arts Department and the director of bands. And we're so glad to see you here this evening. We do have a couple people in the audience I want to recognize. First, we have back up in the top of the mezzanine, one of our members of the Performing Arts Center Wall of Honor. That is Miss Susie Reiser, long time now retired, but long time music teacher in Indian River County. Please give Susie a hand. And then we also have our principal, Mr. Sean O'Keefe, here in the audience. Please give Mr. O'Keefe a hand. This band that you see on stage is our concert band. It is made up predominantly of freshman students. And I want to brag on this group a little bit. A little more than a month ago, they went up to Sebastian and performed and played three pieces at the Florida Bandmasters Association District Concert MPA. And they played for a panel of three adjudicators, and then they sight read, and they received straight superior ratings. We're going to keep things moving as best we can tonight. After each band, we'll have a little bit of a stage change, so just bear with us through that. And on with the concert, and please welcome Miss Russell to the stage. Thank you so much for your patience. This is our Philharmonic Band, and it's made up of students in grades 10 through 12. And I want to brag on this group before they play. And again, back about a month and a half ago, they performed for the FBA Concert MPA, and they've received straight superior ratings on stage. So we're very proud of them. I will say there's a little bit of a program change. The third piece, the British Master Suite, we're only doing the first and the third movement of that piece. We will not be doing the second movement. This year, in our concert band class and in our Philharmonic Band class, we were privileged to be able to have some upper-class students as interns in that class, and we let them do some sectional work, we let them do some rehearsing and just working with students. And we had an intern in this class, Lindsay King, who was our drum major, head drum major this year, and she was also our student conductor. And so she's going to conduct the first piece by Robert Sheldon. So please welcome Lindsay King to the stage.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. This band is our symphonic band, and these are all students in grades 10 through 12. And they, like the other two bands, received straight superiors at district. Now, next Wednesday evening at 6:30 p.m. right here on this stage, they will be one of 63 bands from around the central and southern part of Florida that will be performing here for the Florida Bandmasters Association State Concert Band MPA. And there will be 63 bands from Wednesday at 11 a.m. until Saturday at like 4 p.m. So if it's free, it's open to the public, there's no ticket, it's open seating. If you got nothing else to do, you like hearing band music, you want to come and hear this because it's going to be amazing. There's some of the finest high school bands in Florida and in the southeastern part of the state that'll be playing on this stage. It's going to be just a really fun 4 days. So the three pieces that we're playing are what we're going to play next week at State. And the march, I want to talk just a little bit about this march by John Philip Sousa. Manhattan Beach. It was written in 1893, and it is dedicated to the proprietor of the resort on Manhattan Beach, which Sousa was visited there a lot, and he was a big fan of it. And so he wrote this march and dedicated it to the proprietor and to the resort. And when you get to the trio of the march, you will hear the clarinets play this arpeggiated figure, which is supposed to symbolize the waves and the ocean. And then the final strain is very different than a Sousa final strain. Most Sousa marches end really big. This march, the final strain starts very softly, and it crescendos very loud, and then it decrescendos. And what that is symbolizing is someone walking down the beach, and they're getting closer to a band playing, and then they pass where the band is playing, and it gets softer. And it's one of the very few Sousa marches that ends quietly. So it's a beautiful piece. We hope you enjoy. And the students have been just working very, very hard. And so here is Manhattan Beach.
Thank you.
Thank you again so much for coming. We have one more piece to play for you, and I just wanted to say, because it ends kind of with a bang, so I always think starting concerts and stopping concerts with talking is kind of anticlimactic, so I just wanted to thank you now for coming, and we hope to see you next week here for State, and if not, then our jazz concert is coming up during the first week of May. And that'll be a lot of fun. We have guest soloist Dr. Jacob Craig from First Presbyterian will be soloing on a tune with the band. You won't want to miss that. Here's our last piece. Please welcome Miss Russell to the stage again.
Thank you, Mr. Howell. Just wanted to say a quick word about this piece. This is entitled Mask by Francis Macbeth. And a mask is an event particularly popular in 17th century England, and would include a variety of different performances, ballet, singing, theater, and even acrobatics, and very elaborate costumes and stages. So we are excited to finish our performance with Mask by Francis Macbeth.